the sound that seep the wretch like
the history of the Church of Christ. For one to understand the Church of Christ as we know it today, one must first understand the world of the African-American men that blazed the trail before us. The history of the Lost Church is a history that African-Americans have played a vital role and important role, from the early Restoration period to today's modern era in the church age. The history of the Lost Church is a tale that is told through the blood, sweat, and tears of several great men of God, along with their families. A tale that is deeply rooted in trials and triumphs of these great men of faith, which they are true through the power of God. These men of God, who embodied the spiritual proudness of the great Apostle Paul, forsook all to seek and save the lost, to preach the truth of the gospel of Jesus Christ. The history of the Church of Christ is a history told through the lives and trials of African-American men like Marshall Keeble, R.N. Hogan, Luke Miller, and G.P. Bowser.
George Philip Bowser was born February 17, 1874, in Maury County, about 60 miles south of Nashville, Tennessee. After finishing grade school, he took the opportunity to attend Walden University, where he mastered five languages in addition to English: Greek, Hebrew, French, German, and Latin. GP was very religious in his childhood experience in the Methodist Church, which gave him second thoughts. Sam W. Womack and other Christians in Nashville took interest in him, teaching him the truth, and he soon obeyed the gospel and started preaching it. Even though he lost his left arm early in life in an accident, he became a master printer, and at the age of 28, he edited a newspaper called The Christian Echo. He started a Christian school for black children on Jackson Street in Nashville and opened it on January 6, 1907. He also started schools in Silver Point, near Cookeville, Tennessee, and was instrumental in setting up schools in Detroit, Fort Worth, and a university in Terrell, Texas. This great man dedicated his life to Christian education among blacks. He died March 23, 1950.
Richard Nathaniel Hogan, better known as R.N. Hogan, was born in Monroe County, Arkansas, on November the 20th, 1902. He was sent at a young age to live with the great evangelist G.P. Bowser. Bowser trained Hogan in the ministry and about the dynamics of preaching. Bowser had Hogan memorize whole chapters of the Bible. He began to preach at the age of 13. Bowser enrolled young Hogan in the Silver Point Bible School. He began an illustrious career in preaching, spanning over a half a century. Hogan accepted full-time ministry position in Oklahoma. Brother Hogan first went to Los Angeles to preach in 1937. A year later, he returned to Los Angeles to establish what would become the Figaro Boulevard Church of Christ. Brother Hogan was also responsible for establishing the Los Angeles School of Preaching, administered by the Figaro Church. In 1949, Hogan took over the editorialship of Christian Echo, which he continued to produce well into the 1990s. This great man of God passed from this life on February the 22nd, 1997.
Marshall Keeble was born near Murfreesboro, Tennessee, December 7, 1878. He was the son of former slaves Robert and Mitty Keeble. Marshall Keeble's life work includes being that of a gospel preacher. In 1914, he decided to give up all of his business interests and preach the gospel only. He dedicated himself to evangelistic work, holding gospel meetings in tents, barns, and church buildings. He established over 200 congregations over the next 60 years of preaching. Sometimes, he would baptize over 100 people in a single gospel meeting. Estimates range between 20,000 and 40,000 people as being baptized by this great gospel preacher in his lifetime. He was an evangelist that was most influential among African American and Caucasian people. His preaching took him from Florida to Washington and from California to the Northeast. He made numerous trips to Nigeria, where he had great success in evangelistic efforts. In 1942, he became the first president of the Nashville Christian Institute. The institute opened its doors in 1940 as a night school for adults. Marshall Keble held many religious debates in his lifetime, and he was very successful in the field of debate. It was said that all of his opponents, after facing Marshall Keble, retired from the debating arena. None of them ever came back for a second try. In his lifetime, he worked to overcome many obstacles for African Americans, both in education and preaching the gospel. He broke many of the cultural barriers that separated black and white people. In 2000, the Christian Chronicle named Marshall Keble the most influential preacher among churches of Christ in the decade of the 1940s. Perhaps it could be said that Marshall Keble was the most influential preacher of the gospel of Jesus Christ in the 20th century. Death came to this great man of God April 20th, 1968.
The great man of God, Luke Miller, was born in the year 1902. Brother Miller was a contemporary of Marshall Keble. He was baptized in Decatur, Alabama by the evangelist Marshall Keble himself. After Brother Miller became a Christian, he traveled with Keble as his song leader and did a tremendous job of song leading in many meetings. Luke was instrumental in many meetings when Keble baptized people by the hundreds. After Luke got so many calls, he began preaching the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Marshall Keble always said that Luke preached more like him than any other preacher he trained. In 1934, Brother Luke Miller was struck down by a heart attack. He never fully recovered, but continued to work in the Lord's Church and conducted many meetings. He also worked for the Sixth Street Church of Christ in Port Arthur, Texas. In 1946, Brother Luke Miller conducted a great gospel meeting in the city of Monroe, Louisiana, that was sponsored by the Jackson Street Church of Christ of Monroe, Louisiana. In this glorious outpouring of the Spirit, 26 souls were added to the body of Christ. Of that number, 16 remained steadfast to their confession to the Lord and formed the nucleus of what would become the Briard Street Church of Christ, what would later become the Mark Street Church of Christ, and what now is today the Parkview Drive Church of Christ. This documentation has been inspired by these great men of God and all the great soldiers of Jesus Christ that passed on before us. It is in their memory that we have presented this documentation. Thank you.
Jesus gave me water. And it was not in the well. Well, there was a woman from Samaria came to the well to get some water. There she met a stranger who did a story tell. That a woman dropped a pitcher, she drank and was made richer from the water he gave her. And it was not in the well. Yes, gave her water. Jesus gave her water. Jesus gave her water. I wanna let his praises swell. Jesus gave her water. He gave that woman water. Gave a living, loving, lasting water. And it was not in well. On that woman he had pity. She ran back to the city, crying glory, hallelujah, and did his wonders tell. She left my Savior singing. She came back to him bringing the town seat of the water, Lord. And it was not in the well. Yes, gave her water. Jesus gave her water. Jesus gave her water. I want to let his praises swell. Jesus gave that woman water. Gave her that loving, lasting water. Water. And it was not in the well. Lord, that woman left for shouting. There was no room for doubting that she had met a Savior who did her wonders tell. Every time she doubted him, she started to think about him, the man that gave her that water, Lord. And it was not in the well. Yes, gave her water. Jesus gave her water. Jesus gave her water. I want to let his praises swell. Tell you he gave that woman water. Gave her that loving, lasting water.